Hello everyone. Welcome to QTB bi-weekly meeting. It's been a while since our last QTB meeting. We have been busy for developing some important features for clustering and other cluster related. And that's why we are unable to do our last few QTB meetings. So in this meeting, we will again discuss about the work progress so far. So since our last QTB meeting, we have released QTB 0.11.0. We have added clustering support for Redis, 5.0 and Redis 5.0. And we have added also added Azure and Swift support in OLG. In OLG upstream, then we have added that fork in our that binary in our Postgres. So 0.0.0 was a big step, and we are also working on some new features. I will discuss about those in this meeting. So let's start. So important issues fixed. There was a issue where user is reported that the init containers are not taken from QTB catalog. We usually take image registry address from catalog, but unfortunately the init containers are hard coded. So we have also moved it to QTB catalog, and it is also it is already supported in 0.11.0. The user who are trying to use QTB in offline, the bare metal, they can now do that without any hassle. The next issue we fixed is supporting OLG as in Azure and Swift. To support this, we have added. We have contributed in upstream OLG. We had on here for both Azure and Swift. We have tested it through thing from then. They did not give any review, so the work is good. But they have fixed the whatever they needed in following peers. So we took all of them in our fork binary, and then we forked repo, then we made a binary of that and already added in 0.11.0. We have added a doc about how to use Azure or Swift with newer QTB release. So user who is trying to use Azure or Swift should be able to do it since our last release. There was some issues if user were reporting that PSP enabled clusters and they had to provide the PSP manually, but it was not working for some coding related problem in QTB, but we have added for PSP support in our latest release. And we have created some the essential PSPs in while installing QTB operator. If user want to modify any of them, they can do it after installing, they can just edit the OML or kubectl edit. They can use kubectl edit, and then when they create a database, the operator will use those edited objects. So yeah, the people who are using PSP enabled cluster should be able to do it. Since our last release from 0.11.0. I was searching the CLI problem. Let's see how it is done. It must be there are two parts. One is given in .sh and another one is chart. So let's see the sh part. So these objects are created while installing the kube operator, and if user want to edit, they can edit these OMLs, or not OMLs, they can edit the object by using kubectl, and kubedb will automatically use these names, mongodb or db or mongodb or snapshot. MongoDB DB will be used for all the MongoDB databases, and snapshot will be used for all the MongoDB snapshots, and similarly all the other queues, Elasticsearch or Postgres or other databases, has the same process, same procedure. So it is straightforward from user end, and user must be able to edit it or modify if they want. The next release was customer support for Redis version 5. We had added Redis other versions of Redis, but it was not working in Redis 5. So we have added it in our last release. Redis customer support was added in 0.10.0, but it is not working on for Redis version 5, but it is now working, so user will be able to do it. Another problem fix was this was a problem. We have discussed about it. We have added new ephemeral support, ephemeral storage support in snapshot. So this user was not able to use it in backup schedule. Then we found out we had not added it in backup scheduler. So after that, we have able fixed that, and the user now can use ephemeral storage type for backup scheduler too. This problem was submitted by Endrek. It was quite interesting problem. Since Go 1.11, the DNS resolution got some changes. So it is not working in Kube DNS 1.13 and following. So the problem was, and the Kube DNS was built on 0.11 and somewhat like that, and the link is here, you can read the details. So the problem was fixed by building the peer finder using Go 1.10. That is fixed. If Kube DNS is not used, if Core DNS is used in the cluster, if user would not have faced it, but this cluster was upgraded from previous version, and the previous version was used Kube DNS, so it appeared in this cluster. Anyway, we got the issues and we got it fixed. That's the main part. We had on issues, and also this user submitted one peer question, and the issues was the report replication service template, the service template of CRD was not applied to replica type Postgres nodes. So he submitted on peer, and we have accepted it. So it is merged in our last release. Since now we had one problem, if the database name was similar, doesn't matter whatever namespace it was using, the scheduler or snapshot was failing, because one snapshot in another namespace was trying to take the backup of the database. Maybe the database name was same. So we have changed that. We are now using we are only searching for a running snapshot in only this namespace. The namespace the snapshot is trying to create, only that namespace. So that means it is namespace scope now. So backup scheduler will not find another snapshot in another namespace from now on. Uh, Dennis was created this issue. He also submitted on peer about updating MySQL doc, and it was a pretty good. And thanks to him, I created on MySQL. I had one issue, and there was this Docker's to do list in that issue. So thanks to him, he made a very good documentation. We can also use it to test if everything is working. And it is actually, there's a essential part where the database needs to update from previous version to next version. It cannot just edit the MySQL version and it will be done. That it's not like that. So thanks to him, as though I haven't read it through this, but I had read it and I did not ran it, did not tested it, but I read it, so it should be all, and I will test it in a few days, I guess. Another interesting problem was our meter and validating webhook had same path, where Elasticsearches also denotes validator.kubedb.com, and Elasticsearches also denotes the CRT, kubedb.com CRTs. So when a user uses ES or Elasticsearch.kubedb.com, that is okay. But when user uses Elasticsearches, it sometimes happens to search for validator.kubedb.com, but there is no getter or post method in this. There must not be. So in this function, so it was throwing error. Then we have renamed it to Elasticsearch mutator. Elasticsearch validators. So these objects have changed to the Elasticsearch mutators or validators and other DBs also. And so user should not have faced it from now on. So that was the issue. That was the main couple of issues we have fixed so far in the recent days. We are also working on two big epic peers. One is MongoDB sharding, and another is MySQL sharding, MySQL clustering. MongoDB sharding, MongoDB apk set was already had support, so I was just working. I'm just working on MongoDB sharding, and it is almost done. I'm just doing some last time testing and monitoring changes, also some webhook changes. I don't want webhooks to be a problem for user. I don't want it to be a very thoroughly checked, but at the same time, some things are needed to be set it from user. So it has been added in webhook. So if we see the specs of MongoDB, it is still in draft, but the work is almost done, so I can show it. It has some helper methods. The OML is here. And there will be a topology part, and another is certificate secret. I have moved key file to certificate secret and declared key file as deprecated. User don't need to hassle about it. It will be done in update from kubedb part. The update will be done from kubedb part. In topology, user can provide shard, config server, and mongos. All of them is required. Required means in shard node, user can provide shards and storage, and MongoDB node is common for all of them. And in MongoDB node, it is there are replicas, number of replicas, prefix or resources or config source, and I have also added pod template in topology. In Elasticsearch, user was asking for pod template in topology, and we hadn't done that, but I am doing it from scratch, so I have already added it in MongoDB part, MongoDB topology. And here the replicas is the number of replicas in each replica set of config server or shards. And shards is the number of total shards of shard node. Maybe it is confusing now, but I will write a talk truly and user can understand from that. So other nodes, config server or mongos does not have shards and shards field in it. They only have replicas. That means the number of replicas of the replica set, as they have only one replica set, so that won't be a matter. MySQL clustering, Shrudito is working on MySQL clustering. He has done, he's writing, rewriting the entry point. And I'm also monitoring his work, and the work is, he's almost to the near to the base work. So let's see. Rezone is working on local volume of PostgreSQL all archiving, and the local volume support in OLG upstream is already available, but it was not added in KBB part. So he's working on it, and he has done it. Taking some testing in last time testing. So yeah, that will be done very soon. After that, we are also trying to fix some bug fixes the users are reporting, which are just reporting. That's the work in progress so far. So after adding MySQL and MongoDB support, we will be able to release another 0.12. After adding all the clustering, we're planning to move to version 1, and there is no point in releasing beta versions, not beta but 0. something versions. So we're planning to move forward, and as these are already using in their production, so version 1 is a must to do. So that's all for if anyone have any questions. I guess no questions so far. So thanks for joining. Looking forward to see you in next meeting. I'm ending the recording. Thank you.